Hello, everyone. It is Craig here at Epcot. I'm standing right at the entrance to World Showcase, and the reason I am here today is because Disney invited myself and Corey out here to check out a little bit of what's happening at Epcot for Festival of the Holidays. I have no idea where Corey is right now. He's probably running around somewhere taking pictures behind me, beside me. I just don't know. But yeah, I really have zero game plan for today. We're going to check out a little bit of all the offerings of everything happening here and maybe some surprises, who knows. But let's go ahead and get things going. Have had quite the long day already just walking around and seeing some of the decorations put up in Future World and World Showcase for Christmas, and you know, it looks really beautiful. I love this time of year, and Epcot feels like it's been decked out more than ever before. I don't know if it's just my bad memory, but I feel like basically every country except China, Japan, and Morocco have gotten at least a little bit of decorations added to them. And you know, that's just decorations. You can't even then include, you then have to include also the entertainment that's going on and all the 15 different food booths that are set up throughout the World Showcase that's providing some holiday food for you. And I've actually had the chance to try some of them at the little media get together that we did have, and so I'm gonna take you through as best as I can. It's a lot to go through. The first thing that I tried was from the Festive Center, and that's in the Odyssey, which is that building between Test Track and World Showcase, if you are not familiar with it. And the big thing about this place is the cookie nook, and there are a lot of different types of cookies. There's snowflake sugar cookies, snickerdoodles, double chocolate peppermint, ginger snap cookie, a Zucker tort, gingerbread. I mean, just so much. And I was able to try a couple of them. I had the double chocolate peppermint cookie, and that one was actually perfect. I was worried about it being too chocolatey when it said double chocolate, but I think it was actually the perfect amount. Add on top of that the peppermint, it just really balanced out together very well. I also did the ginger snap cookie with cream cheese icing and cranberry jam. This thing was sweet, like very, very sweet, and a lot of it's coming from the cream cheese. So if you're not a big cream cheese fan, then I don't know if you'll really enjoy that. Sorry about all the noise in the background as well, too. And then the third cookie that I did try was the gingerbread man cookie, and that was actually good gingerbread. So I'm a fan. If you're not a fan of gingerbread, probably won't be your thing. They also had for us to try the Central 28 Beer Company Joy from the World Holiday Double, and it actually wasn't that bad. It's a local brewery from DeBary, Florida, and I would definitely go back and get this again. The next place we tried from was the Feast of the Three Kings booth that is near the Showcase Plaza, and here we tried the roasted pork with mashed yuca and pickled green bananas, and this was pretty good. So I'm hit or miss on yuca, and I thought that the yuca in this situation was really good, and the pickled green bananas added a lot of extra spice. So if you're not into spiciness, this one might not be the thing for you, but I enjoyed it. The next thing we had was in Germany at the Bavaria Holiday Kitchen, the cheese fondue that's served in a bread bowl with baby vegetables and marbled potatoes, and this is just awesome. I think it's a mixture of like Swiss and Gruyere in terms of the fondue, so just be aware of that. I know that a lot of people out there don't really like Swiss cheese. They think it has a weird flavor to it. I loved it. The vegetables that they give you with it are like little zucchinis, carrots, and then like I said, the potatoes, and it's really, really good. So it might not be great on a really hot day, but it hit the spot for me. So I do recommend that one. The next thing that we tried was from the American Adventure Pavilion. The American Holiday Table has the slow roasted turkey with stuffing, mashed potatoes, green beans, and cranberry sauce. This was, you know, good Thanksgiving dinner on a plate. Nothing really to write home about. So it's Thanksgiving food. It's every place does it, and you probably have your favorite. I don't know if this one's going to be it, but I wouldn't tell you not to get it either if it's what you're in the mood for. Moving on, then, we had a lot from Canada. I believe that's what rounded out most of everything at the Yukon Holiday Kitchen. We had the seared salmon from there, which included Crown Royal Maple Whiskey Glaze, Parsnip Silk, Apple Chutney, and Hazelnut Croquant. And this was really, really good. You could taste the whiskey a little bit in the maple, but I thought the maple balanced out with the salmon very, very well. This was an extremely tasty dish. They also had the traditional French-Canadian tuterie with Canadian ketchup, and I guess this was a mixture of beef and lamb inside kind of a pastry, and that was served within that Canadian ketchup, which was more like a barbecue sauce and had a little bit of a zip to it. I love this. It was very filling too. So if you're looking for a small tasting portion but still get a little full off of it, this probably is something to look for. And then in terms of drinks here, we had a sampling of two different ice wines and a cider. That was the Chateau de Charmey Riesling ice wine, the I don't know how to pronounce it, apple ice cider, and a Redstone Cabernet Franc ice wine, and these were actually really good. I'm not a huge fan of ice wines and ciders because of how sweet they are, but you know, they tasted good with the food that I was getting, especially from the Canada Pavilion. So lots of good food items, and that's all I've tried so far. So I need to come back and get plenty more, and I will do that in my own time. But the next thing up that I think I need to hit is the Candlelight Processional. I'm going to go to the first showing of that, and tonight the narrator is Anna Gasteyer, which I'm very excited for, so I'm going to go get ready for that, and I hope you enjoy watching a little bit of it here, too.
Of Liberty and Epcot's Candlelight Processional.
Gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. I'm not sure if you know this, but Walt Disney began this tradition of the Candlelight Processional at Disneyland. And for over 50 years, literally millions of guests have enjoyed the Christmas story, the traditional carols, and especially the glorious music of the holiday season. So now, I invite you to sit back and enjoy our magnificent orchestra and singers. Now, let us begin. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." There were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." It is a gift bestowed upon us all during this special time of year. Tonight, people around the world mark this joyful season with heartfelt sentiment. As we each treasure our own unique holiday traditions of family, faith, and culture, let us join together in celebrating the birth of a blessed babe in a manger, and rejoice in the universal message of peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Joy to the world.
Nature, save, nature, save, nature, save, nature, save.
Well, that was the Candlelight Processional with Anna Gasteyer, which was just outstanding. If you ever have the chance to see her in the future, I highly recommend it. She just did a wonderful job telling the whole story, and everything else about it was great, as always. I forgot to also mention, on my way to Candlelight Processional, I also got a chance to check out, I believe they're called El Mariachi Coco de Santa Cecilia, and that is the limited time act that is here playing songs at Mexico, and they're playing songs from Coco, so take a second and check it out because it's pretty cool.
Far away, I hold you in my heart. Sing a secret song to you. Tonight we are apart. Remember, to travel far. Remember me. This time you hear a sad guitar. Know that I'm with you the only way that I can be. Until you're in my arms again. Remember me. Secret song to you, tonight we are apart. Remember, though I have to travel far. Remember me, each time you hear a sad guitar. Know that I'm with you the only way that I can be. Until you're in my arms again. Remember me. Hola muchachos, amigos. Día de los Muertos is a time to remember our loved ones. Each year, we make a beautiful altar of remembrance called an ofrenda, like this one. In some ways, this ofrenda is just like the one that Miguel and his family build in the movie Coco. It is decorated with pictures and other wonderful mementos of our loved ones. You see, we believe that the glow of the beautiful miracles, the cempasúchil, will help them find their way home. Remember me, though I have to travel far. Remember me, each time you hear a sad guitar. Know that I'm with you the only way that I can be. Until you're in my arms again. Remember me. It's señor, thank you.
Sí, señor.
After I left the Candlelight Processional, I then headed straight to Morocco so I could see one of the new acts here this year at the Festival of the Holidays, and that is Mostly Kosher. And just take a look for one second and see how they are.
So, this is the time of year that we gather with our family and our friends to celebrate Hanukkah, Festival of Lights. We give gifts, we play games, and of course,
we eat!
On each night of Hanukkah, we light the Hanukkah menorah. It's a candelabra whose oil miraculously kept the lamps burning for 8 days in the holy temples all those years ago. And today, those 8 lights, they sit in windowsills all over the world, bringing hope and joy and comfort. Light the first of 8 tonight, the farthest candle to the right. Light the first and second too. When tomorrow's day is through, light 3 and light 4. Every dusk, light 1 candle more. Till all 8 burn bright and high. And we all remember why we light the candles every night.
Yeshuati lehanna lechate ya ti kon beitei lati be sham toda mezabeya. Song, praise your saving power. You amidst the raging foes were our sheltering tower. Furious they assailed us, but your arms availed us, and thy word broke their sword. When our own strength failed us, and thy word broke their sword, when our own strength failed us.
I don't know if that came out as good on video as it was in person, but they were awesome. This is one of the best acts I've ever seen in Epcot, like, period. They just were so energetic, they were talented. It was just a joy to watch, and I'm not being facetious or sarcastic at all when I say that. I will be back multiple times to see them throughout the rest of the holiday season here, but I'm unfortunately getting a little bit tired. I think it shows on my face right now. I've been here for hours and hours and hours, so I'm going to actually take off, and I will be back at Epcot again. I'll be back making other videos again, honestly. You know that. So if you enjoyed this, make sure to leave comments down below about it. Hit that thumbs up button. Share it with a friend. Do all that good stuff. And I will see you again next time, everyone. Take care. Merry Christmas.
Open your eyes. Right here. Stay.